Hi, my name is Dr. Michael Veslak. I'm a chiropractor in Camarillo, California, board certified in integrative medicine, and I'm a certified functional medicine practitioner. Today we're going to talk about spinal stenosis, the non-surgical approach to this particular malady. So some of the symptoms, if you're suffering from spinal stenosis, you'll be very well aware of these, but you can have neck and or back pain, numbness or tingling in your arms and or legs. It's usually worse upon walking or prolonged standing, and you have relief usually with rest and or sitting and sometimes bending forward. So it's the individual in the severe case or moderate to severe case that you see kind of hunched over, kind of walking around like this. They're doing that to open up their spinal canal and give them some relief. So bending forward gives the spinal stenosis patient relief. Some of the causes are narrowing of the spinal canal. So when they bend forward, they're actually opening that canal up. Arthritis is a cause of narrowing of that spinal canal. Sometimes a disc protrusion and or herniation in the canal limits the size of that canal. And then you can have an enlarged ligament, a hypertrophied ligament that can also limit the size of the canal. Usually with a stenotic patient, they're generally over, I'll say 50, 55 years old. They will have usually a combination of these three things. It's usually just not one problem. The diagnosis is generally by a physical examination. Again, it's relief with forward bending and pain upon backward bending. They'll have MRI, will show a narrowing of the spinal canal due to those factors that I listed above, the degeneration, arthritis, the disc herniation or protrusion, and the hypertrophied ligament. It's usually a gradual onset, and it slowly kind of creeps up on you until one day it's really limiting your ability to participate in the things that you like to enjoy in your life. The relief is with rest, more pain on activity, and the pain is usually on an intermittent basis. So the traditional approach is, one is surgical intervention to increase the size of the canal, that increase the size of the foramen. So they do this through a laminectomy. Sometimes exercise are given through physical therapy and or chiropractic. Medication, sometimes an epidural shot, which I have found not to be very effective for a stenotic type patient. And then you have to start to limit your activity. You're having difficulty walking or standing. You're thinking about, you know, should you travel like you used to, and different things is always in the back of your mind. Are you going to be able to handle that? So our approach is a little bit different. We utilize kind of several different things. First, we found the spinal decompression to be extremely effective because what it does, it actually opens up that canal by increasing slightly that disc space. And sometimes we're just talking about 1 millimeter change and the symptoms are relieved. We give very, very specific spinal stenosis exercises. We'll usually layer one each week, not to overload the patient, and through time the patient becomes much more stronger and able to participate in the things that they like to do. We like to get to the root cause of the inflammation. What's always struck me as a practitioner, especially when I first started out, I would see an x-ray and I would see severe arthritis and the patient wouldn't have any pain. And then I would see a patient that had mild arthritis and they'd be in extreme pain, but their diagnosis was arthritis. And it just never really made sense to me. And the more that I practice, I realized that inflammation is actually the driving cause. So if you have two patients that have, let's say, about the same level of arthritis and narrowing of the canal, the individual that has the inflammation is the one that's going to be in the pain and discomfort. So it is the common thread that I've seen with all really chronic pain patients, and especially spinal stenosis, that there is an underlying metabolic inflammatory issue. So functional medicine allows us or me to determine the cause of what is actually driving that inflammation. And once we remove that cause, along with the other treatment recommendations that I previously gave with the spinal decompression, the exercises, patients see a significant improvement in their stenotic condition. We'll also give stimulation of the nerve fibers, the small nerve fibers that cause the neuropathy, as well as some of the large diameter afferent fibers. This will help with proprioception, balance, coordination, And we also do some exercise which evaluates the patient's center pressure. It's where our body perceives us to be in space. And there's ways to do this and ways for you to change this, as you'll see when you come to our office. So we give very, very specific exercise to enhance balance, coordination, and proprioception. So our approach is completely non-surgical. It is safe, it's effective, there are no drugs, we have a very high success rate, and what we have found is the approach when you treat stenosis has to be this comprehensive. If you only handle one part of it, like an epidural, and sometimes even just the surgery or the exercise by itself, we have not seen a really good success rate with the patients that we've treated. So most of these folks that have come to see us, they've already had all these procedures and we're basically kind of the last stop. You know, they've been 8, 10 other places, and then we seem to get pretty good results with this when we do this comprehensive